New bombshell recordings expose Russian Clinton scheme, Sessions needs to lock her up. For almost 2 years, Americans have been forced to listen to the left complain about Russia. Since before the election, they've blamed Russia for every problem they've faced. They want us to believe that President Donald Trump got into office thanks to the help of shadowy figures from the former Soviet superpower. However, new details are emerging that cast a very different light on the story after a new bombshell recording exposed a Russian Clinton scheme that has people screaming for Attorney General Jeff Sessions to lock her up. We know that Democrats are good at blaming others for the very things they are guilty of. While they accuse Trump of colluding with Russia, we see time and again evidence that it was Hillary Clinton and Barack Obama who were getting cozy with the Russians. During the Obama administration, it was Hillary Clinton's State Department that agreed to sell 20% of U.S. uranium production to the Russians. It was Hillary Clinton who offered Putin that obnoxious reset button stunned, in a desperate attempt to appease the leader. In addition, more and more evidence is emerging that the Democrats were behind the so-called Russian dossier. They worked with Russian agents to produce a false document, in the hopes of smearing Donald Trump. Now, new audio recordings have been discovered that reveal how confident Russian officials were that they could buy and sell top Democratic leaders. In an appearance Tuesday on Fox News Channel's Hannity, Breitbart editor-at-large Peter Schweizer, president of the Government Accountability Institute and author of Clinton Cash, revealed there were audio recordings of Russian officials demonstrating they were willing to use bribery to get favors from the former President Bill Clinton and his wife, former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. According to Schweizer, that included giving donations to the Clinton Foundation. He added that had there been this body of evidence compiled on anyone else in an elected office, from President Donald Trump on down, they would be under investigation. During the time that Congress was approving the U.S.-Russia uranium deal, there was an FBI investigation into Russian agents. They were attempting to bribe U.S. officials. Then President Barack Obama covered it up, but now, we are learning just who the Russians were trying to bribe. There were several facts that no one debates. Fact number one. You have the Kazakh uranium minister Mavtrin Sakhachev in a 2010 video deposition describing in great detail how Bill and Hillary Clinton shook him down and shook down Kazakh officials to compel them to give uranium assets to Frank Justra, who was the founder of Uranium One. We now have this whistleblower that has come forward who reportedly has audio recordings of Russian officials talking about using bribery to get favors from the Clintons, giving donations to the Clinton Foundation. Source, Fox News. This report comes after days of speculation that Attorney General Jeff Sessions is about to appoint a special investigator to go after Hillary Clinton and her foundation. Even Congress called Sessions to testify, hoping to uncover what his plans are. Now, we are learning that there are recordings documenting Russia's role in all this. There is ample evidence to suggest that the Clintons colluded with Russia to hand over our uranium, to the tune of millions. So, why hasn't there been an investigation? Why has there been so much attention placed on Mueller's investigation into Russia interference in the election, but zero attention on this scandal? If our Justice Department started a serious investigation into the matter, they would quickly uncover the corruption. The left would fall like dominoes, as they have a poor defense. The Clinton defense thus far has been pitiful. The fact of the matter is bribery exists whether it's a close vote or not. The second offense, Hillary Clinton is saying that she was not involved in the decision. I'm sorry, but she does not have a great track record of speaking the truth. The person that they sort of prop out, Assistant Secretary of State Fernandez, to say she was not involved in this decision, 4 days before he first made that statement, Sean, he is in the Podesta email saying he wants to do whatever he can to help Hillary Clinton get elected. He is not a disinterested party. This has to be investigated. Source, Breitbart. If Sessions' DOJ doesn't look into this case, then it would be a travesty of justice. Americans want the truth. We have grown tired of the media attacking our president over rumors and lies, while real criminals walk free.